This is the BrO3- Lewis structure. Bromine has 7 valence electrons, oxygen has 6, we have 3 oxygens, and then we need to add this extra valence electron here for a total of 26 valence electrons for BrO3-. Bromine is the least electronegative, we'll put that at the center, and we'll put the oxygens on the outside. Since we have a total of 26 valence electrons, we'll put 2 between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used 6, and we'll go around the oxygens and fill their octets. 8, 10, 24, and then back to the bromine, 26. We've used all the valence electrons, and we can see that each of the atoms has 8 valence electrons, so the octets are full for all of the atoms. At this point, it looks like we have a pretty good Lewis structure. However, bromine is below period 2, row 2, on the periodic table. It can have an expanded octet, meaning it can have more than 8 valence electrons. So we should look at our formal charges to make sure this is the most likely Lewis structure for BrO3-. For bromine, we have 7 valence electrons from the periodic table, minus the non-bonding, these two right here, minus the bonding. We have 2, 4, and 6. 6 divided by 2. That gives us a plus 2 formal charge on the bromine. For the oxygen, and each of the oxygens is the same, so we'll just do 1. We have 6 valence electrons on the periodic table, minus non-bonding, 6 minus the bonding, 2 divided by 2, so we have a negative 1 formal charge on each of the oxygens. We'd like our formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible. Of course, we'll still have a negative 1 here, so we'll have to have a negative 1. To do that, we can take and form double bonds with the oxygens and the bromines. Let's take these valence electrons here and share them to form a double bond. If we were to recalculate our formal charges, you'd see now the oxygen has a formal charge of 0, this oxygen, and the bromine, instead of a plus 2, will have a plus 1. So let's do one more oxygen and form a double bond here. Now the formal charge on this oxygen is 0. The bromine has a formal charge of 0, and this is still negative 1. That makes sense. The total charge, formal charge here, is negative 1, and that matches with the negative 1 here. One last thing we need to do. This is a negative ion, the BrO3 negative ion, bromate ion. We need to put brackets around the structure to show that it is a negative ion. So that's the Lewis structure for BrO3-. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.